Hey y'all, how you doing today? Today is December 7th, 2014. Something happened on December 7th, 1941. It's called the invasion or attack on Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, our naval base. And a lot of men died, women died, and drew us into World War II. Anyway, don't forget about that, okay? I just wanted to mention that. Know how, today we're gonna make fried pork chops. And the recipe was passed to me verbally by a friend, JR. I don't have the recipe, but we'll have to make one up. But he verbally told me what to do, so let's get started. Lovely pork chops that I bought at Staple Street Meat Market. Always a good place to shop. The meat is fresh and it's quality, and it's not, has just enough marbling to give it flavor, but it's not crazy marbling, you know, like other places. Anyway, what we got here is about an eighth of a cup. Let me just show y'all. Eighth of a cup of olive oil. Pour it right in there. Let me move these pork chops back for a second. Alright. Then this recipe is not Sapo's fried pork chops. I'm going to call this one JR's fried pork chops. You'll see why later. Anyway, get your Chiasson's. The seasoning for grilling and baking. That's the one you want to have. This can't be replicated, folks, unless you get this. This isn't any plain Cajun rub. This is special. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to get a tablespoon. And we're not going to do it like that. We're going to do it like this. There's a tablespoon. Bam. Put it in there. All righty. Same thing. Don't go buy no McCormick's or nothing like that. You gotta get Chiasson's. Rub it, lemon pepper. Because it's low sodium and it's good. So this, we're gonna get a half a teaspoon. Let me find that. Just a half a teaspoon. You open the lid of this, you can smell it right away. You get some of it's granulated right there. Put that in there. There you go, folks. Then we got to get some kind of stirring device. Something I'm always lacking. Here we go. I'm going to use a fork. Let's just kind of get down in there and see what we're doing here. There you go. Here's your little mixture. You're going to go ahead and mix this up. I'm going to make you a little paste, okay? It's mixed up enough. Okay, let me get this, and we'll show you how to do this. Okay, here's the paste we just made. Stir it up. Get it up in this little broom paintbrush, and just coat it on there. Like a paste. Get it on there. Get it all over these babies. Don't be shy, folks. Use it up and get some more. Okay, flip it over. I'm doing five pork chops, so if you do five or more, you're going to go ahead and multiply the recipe, the paste recipe. Okay. for good measure, that's what we're going to do. Don't worry about it, folks. At the end, we can do anything we want once the food is done. All right, folks, I got to go a little old school. Well, I don't know how I could say that when they didn't have these back in the day. But no, how I just toasted some bread here. I'm going to make my own breadcrumbs. So we're just going to throw these up in here like this. You know, the routine, just throw them in. We're going to test this thing out that I bought here. I've used it for other stuff, but not for bread. Let's see what it makes. It's supposed to work. Probably just going to spin around in circles, not do anything. Nah, it's a ninja. Ninjas are soldiers. So we'll see. I'm getting it kind of packed up in there. Maybe I got to try it first before I get carried away. All right. You put this on something like that all the way down. Then you lay this in here. Let's get the ninja emblem to the front. And then let's get a zoom in so you can see the stuff. The bread turn into powder, hopefully. Seems like it worked pretty good. Let's see what we got, folks. In the back. Oh, you can see right there. Put a couple more last pieces in there. Yeah. Why buy breadcrumbs? Just make them. Come on. Get in there. And the last of it. Keep pushing up and down like that. Ta-da! Breadcrumbs. New school. And just take this out. Take that out. And there you have it, folks. Got you some breadcrumbs. Let me get the breadcrumbs ready for the pork chops that have been seasoned with the chiassons. Here we have a pan. We're just going to use this to put the breadcrumbs in. Just throw them in there. Don't worry about it. Still kind of hot. I hope I have enough. If I don't, then I always wish I did. So, get you a pork chop. Don't worry about putting gloves on. So, we're cooking it for ourselves, not for the general public. Put them in there. Flip it. Flip it. Again. Get you a spoon or something. Scoop some of that up. Flip it around. Don't worry about it, folks. It's all good. Just bread. There we go. Got two for frying, no how. Alright. Now, next place we're going to stop is the frying pan. This is a frying pan. You can tell it's good metal by the ring it has. So what we're going to do, we're going to get a spatula. Get our oil moved around in there. We've got about a, I don't know how much. This is a big frying pan, but not very much. Just enough for the bottom there. Get you about on medium. Let's just get one of these babies and put them in there. Grab it by the bone. There we go. Okay, we got our pork chop in there now. And you see, it's on medium. So we're going to cook it nice and slow. We'll flip it here in a minute. Okay, it's been about 2 minutes or 3 minutes. Let's see what we got here. Flip it over. There you go, folks. It's still a little bit not crunchy yet, but it is pretty. So keep going. So you want that, you want this to be crunchy. Like this part right here. Oh, I didn't mean to use my finger. My middle finger, I mean. This part right here, crunchy. This is still kind of bready, so we're gonna keep going. We'll keep checking it. Okay, this side should be done. I like to move it around in the oil because my pan, my top is uneven, so I like to move it around in that hot oil and get it to get some more on there. That looks really lovely right there. Let me zoom in for y'all. There you go. And we're gonna do the other side one more time. Then we're gonna go back. That's it. Not too much on this side because it was looking a little darker. Just wanted to get this to firm up. So it's a little bit above medium, the stove. Alright. Okay, one more flip on this side. That's already nice and crunchy. We're just going to give this side now one more, and then that's it, folks. And we will set that to the side. I will cook the rest after I test it. Which there's really no testing. I'm going to call it tasting. Ain't nothing to test about Chiasson. I already tasted all the rub. And before you put it on food, you just taste it with a spoon. And you know within 30 seconds that it's a high-quality product that you can't get anywhere. Maybe in around New Orleans or all over Louisiana, but the rest of you folks around God's green earth, you got to go to the website and, like I said, get you some. Okay. It's ready, man. Let's get it out of there. It's lovely. Let's see the other side. See all that beautiful breadcrumbs all browned up right there? You see that, folks? This is a nice Christmas plate. We're going to let it rest a little bit so it don't burn my tongue. And then we'll go ahead and taste it. Taste it, not test it. Taste it. You heard. Alrighty, folks. Here we have the infamous JR. JR's pork chop. Fried pork chop. JR. My friend JR. Let's just go ahead and cut into this baby. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Well, don't me. Get a couple pieces here. Got my fillet knife out. We ain't doing no filleting now, man. Fixing to eat. Anyway, this is beautiful, folks. Let me just get this and show you. Look at this beautiful pork chop from Staple Street Meat Market, Corpus Christi, Texas. The rub is from Chiasson's seasoning. And the breadcrumbs are from H-E-B. So, without further ado, let's turn the camera around and taste it out. All right. First, got to show you the rubs. Lemon pepper. And this one is a Chiasson's Just Rub It, yeah. Seasoning and grilling and baking meats and seafood and anything that you want. Okay, here they are. This is the JR pork chop. And I haven't cheated now. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm fixing to. The dog knows what's up. She's right down there. Oh, man. That's better than anything, any restaurant, anything around. Look at that, folks. It's good. Man, thanks, JR. This is good. I might eat 5 pork chops right now. I don't have to have no side order, side dish. But hats off. Well, my hat's already off. Bow down to a good product. Chiasson's seasoning. Go get you some, folks. And also, bow, hats off already. Staple Street Meat Market. Good. All I could say is good. Never, ever, ever had a problem from that place. I go in there and I just see the cooler full of fresh meat, ready to go home to my house and be cooked. So, get over there at Staple Street Meat Market and order some Chiasson's seasoning from the web, or go visit them if you live in Louisiana. No help. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it, and I'll catch up to you next time. God bless you. Adios. Bon vie, and good night.